Dahil pag kinuha mo, nilamangan mo siya. O ito, pinapakita ko yung binibigay sa inyo. Partingan nyo. Yan ang sales invoice na binibigay, hindi certificate of registration. I'm putting that as exhibit. Ayan ang isa sa ating mga kwan. At ebidensya sa inyo, kung hindi nyo alam. Ito, ang pangalan nito, DES, Strong Motors Incorporated, MC Briones Highway, Mandawi City. Oh, sold to Enoch Eduardo B. December 1919, Curug 7, Labadyangan, Compostela, Cebu. Model, 1 Honda, 2NY25MK. Pati engine, naan dyan. Magkano? Total sales, 73,100. Less VAT, 7,832.14. Amount net of VAT, 65,000. Total amount due, 73,100. Papalabasin nyo, nabinayaran ng buo yan, pero ang totoo, inutang yan para hindi na kayo dadaan sa registration of deeds. Inutang yan para hindi na kayo dadaan doon, para hawak na lang nyo. Itong hawak nyo, wala siyang certificate na nagbayad siya, wala siyang certificate of ownership, at wala rin siyang tinatawag na plaka. Kaya, kayang-kaya siyang tisirin, kaya-kaya siyang pisilin, kaya siyang kunin yung kanyang motorsiklo dahil hindi niya kaya magbayad ng 36%. In the words of a famous man here in this country, putang ina! Mahiya naman tayo. I'm just quoting. Galit na ang tao sa inyo. Dapat ayusin nyo. Dami ng pinapatay. Kinakalapan ninyo. I am convinced, I'm going to tell you, LTO is incompetent. It has no compassion. It is negligent. Wala kayong ginagawa. You have apathy. Wala kayong pakialam kung ano mangyari sa tao na mamatay. Wala kayong effort na bilisan yung plaka. Wala kayong news about it. Wala kayong sinasabi. You thrive in the silence of the people. Namawala yung motorsiklo, baliwala sa inyo. Deliberate na tinatanggal ang plaka. Walang testigo dahil sa inyo. And that is why I'm saying to you in no uncertain terms, magalit na kayo. I don't mind. But you have to do it. Do not trifle with the Senate, especially the Blue Ribbon Committee. That's why we're here. Oh, I will ask another question. Bukod sa taxes, will the BIR please compute for me next week, next time we have a hearing? You better report how much taxes you collect every year from the motorcycles. Is that clear, Mr. Bernardino?
In that case, Your Honor, if it pertains to the total tax collections, we will need to have... it will be under the confidentiality rule under Section 270 of the Tax Code, Your Honor.
But this is a general statement of how much you collect. You mean to tell me you're exempted from telling your Senate, who decides on the budget, how much you collect totally? I'm not asking you for individual taxes.
Okay, Your Honor. We will note that request, Your Honor.
Okay. The answer is yes, sir.
Yes, Your Honor.
Now, I ask again, DOTR, is there anybody from DOTR? Undersecretary?
Yebra.
Yes, you're still there?
Yes, Your Honor, andito po.
Yes.
We are here, Your Honor.
What is the plan of DOTR in solving the conflicting interests of PPI, JKG, yung isang bidder ninyo, and Trojan, JH, Tongis? Di ba may conflicting interest yan? Kaya may kapos kayong dalawang taon na hindi nabigyan ng plaka? Totoo po ba yan?
Go ahead, 16, please.
Excuse me?
Yes, Mr. Chair. Good afternoon po. Steve Pastor po from the Department of Transportation. Yes, Mr. Chair. We are in full coordination with our LTO po with regard to resolving the issues of the procurement issues po of LTO with regard to the conflicting bidders for the plate numbers po.
How long will it take you to solve that problem so that our people will not suffer any longer? And why are you not investigating this? Why does it take the Senate to investigate all the shenanigans there of motorcycles being sold for at 36% interest, or for that matter, not being given a certificate of registration, and they're being given invoices which are arbitrary, capricious, and utterly corrupt? What are you doing about that?
Mr. Chair, we are in full coordination po with LTO, and we have given the directive po to resolve the matter at the soonest possible time. To cite an example, Mr. Chair, there was an issue in Cebu with regard to certain manufacturers, and we coordinated with LTO in Region 7, Your Honor, that it should be resolved already, that this disadvantageous acts of manufacturers be restrained or be completely stopped by the local by our local LTO in that region, Your Honor.
Okay, I heard you loud and clear. That's good. But these are not only disadvantageous. Will you agree with me that these are abusive?
Yes, Mr. Chair. Yes, Your Honor.
Okay, they're big people pressing Region 7 that they should not interfere with what is happening there because there are many big people involved?
Yes, Your Honor.
Do you know who they are? I'm not going to ask a question. We're lawyers. I ask questions that I know the answer for. I just want you to know. What is the answer? Where is the paper? Remember, you're under oath. You just said yes, there are big people. Who are these big people? What was it, Dario?
I'm not...
Some big personalities, Mr. Undersecretary, and you said so yourself, that are intervening in behalf of these big four. I don't mind. Sometimes we politicians have to ask, but not to intervene. And if you look at, you know, we research here, you know, I don't need anybody from your office. We research here. If you look at CNN, if you look at all the newspapers concerning that case, it is there. Here, I will show you. There is a back and forth because some people are being accused of this and then they're pressing that they should not intervene. They should not touch this big four. They are untouchable. Are you aware of that? That's why you said, that's why we're fixing the problem within Region 7 and the people involved, right? You said that because they're doing disadvantageous things. And I corrected you. They're not doing disadvantageous things. They are really abusing. Tapos binabaliktad pa yung mga tao. Oh, abangan na lang sa susunod na kabanata. Tatawagin ko na mismo dapat si Secretary ng DOTR. Tugade. Hindi kayo makasagot. You know, all these things involve life, loss of life, involve grinding poverty, abusing the poor, abusing yung mga maliliit na nagmamayari ng motorsiklo na nangangarap na madala niya yung pamilya na hindi na siya mamamasahe, makabawas sa pamasahe. Lahat siya ginagawa. Kasama rin dyan yung pagpapayaman ng ilan. Mayaman na, nagpapayaman pa ng todo-todo. Kasama rin dyan yung nagmamalaki na may mga malalaking tao na sinasabi, sikat sila at hindi sila dapat pakialaman. We will not tolerate that. Please inform your Secretary of Transportation that we will go all out and leave no stone unturned to stop this. LTO is not exactly a beautiful area right now. Meron pa kayong bago. Yung ginagawa nyo na bagong motor vehicle inspection system or center na binago na naman nyo. Nagagalit ang tao dahil una pinag-check nyo yung engine emission. Ngayon nagpagawa kayo ng malalaking sistema na bawat sasakyan sisingilin nyo magkano? 1.8. Nagsusumbong na naman yung mga tao. Nagsusumbong kay Senator Poe. Do you think we're stupid here? Do you think we're blind and deaf to the people? Mr. Secretary, do you have an answer?
Yes, Your Honor, we are aware po of the certain issues po with the MBIS and we will attend po the hearing set by the Committee of Senator Grace po next week.
That's good, because I'll be there as well. But we will also conduct another Blue Ribbon hearing. And we will go all out to make sure that we ferret out all the shenanigans that's going on out there, the foolish people there, even the business who are performing unethical acts. This is a case which involves the masa, yung masang Pilipino na gusto lang umabante. You wouldn't even think yung kita nila ay masasaktan ka. Sila yung maliit na kita mahalaga sa kanila tapos titirahin ng 36%. Wala pang security. Babawiin yung motorsiklo pag hindi nakabayad at kailangan pa singilin ng insurance. Hindi nyo pinoproteksyonan yan. Nakalagay sa Constitution yan. We must protect the people. You took an oath like me. Diba? Maintenance of peace and order. Protection of the life, liberty, and property. 1987 Philippine Constitution, Article 2, Section 5. Have you forgotten your Constitution, sir?
No, Mr. Chair, Your Honor.
Well, I'm not mad at you. I'm just mad at the system. I know you're trying to do your job, but do it well. Stand fast. Have a brave heart. Make sure you protect the people.
Yes, Your Honor.
Is that too corny for you?
Hindi po, Your Honor, Mr.
Where
Chair.
Where did you graduate?
San Beda College of Law, Mr. Chair.
Wow, San Beda. All my staff here are San Beda people. And they know how hard I work. That's why we leave no stone unturned. It's a great school. But of course, UP is a little better. Tawa-tawa ka dyan. Magalit sa akin yung mga kasama ko sa Ateneo. It doesn't matter what school you attended. It is your heart that matters. When you die, God will measure the size of your heart for the people, not the size of your brain.
Yes, Your Honor. Thank you for that, Your Honor.
Thank you. So pray a little. Pray for wisdom all the time and pray to do the right thing all the time. You may not be able to do the right thing, but sometimes we try as hard as we can, so we do most of the things right. And if we fail, we suffer penance for it. And if we're at fault, we own up to it. I can't see LTO owning up to all this. Can you imagine? April, natapos yung batas. March 19, hindi ko nagmakamali. March 8, 2019. Pakinggan mo ako, ha, Panyero. March 8, 2019, approved. RA 11235. March 14, it was published. March 29, effectivity. pinublish sa Official Gazette, March 29, 2019. June 27, 2019, date when IRR was completed. Must have been completed. Dapat na complete ang June 27, 2019. In-extending nyo ginawang May 11, 2020 actual completion. Mukhang dinadrag yung paa eh. June 30, 2019, date when motorcycles with plates not in conformity with the law must renew the registration and apply for the required readable number plates pursuant to section 19 of RA 11235. Do you know we put that in the law na dapat pag ikaw ay nagparehistro within 5 days namili ka ng motorsiklo sa, para maproteksyonan ang tao, may proteksyon na sila, meron na kagad ibibigay sa kanilang certificate of registration at saka plaka. Do you know that? Be honest, is this the first time you're knowing it?
No, Your Honor. I read the law, Your Honor. We are.
Well, if you read the law, then you must enforce it. You're yes, legal, sir. Right? You're the legal officer?
No, Your Honor. I am the Assistant Secretary for Road Transport. The legal, the Undersecretary for Legal is Yusek Quiebra po. He's also in this call, Your Honor.
Is he there?
I'm here, Mr. Chair.
Yeah. Oh, what do you say?
Tama po kayo, Mr. Chair. Klaro po yung batas with respect to the effectivity and implementation. And we understand yung points pa rin yan. We apologize po, Mr. Chair.
Thank you. This is big enough. I don't need an apology. I just need a sincere heart to say this is not going to happen. We're going to push this through too. We'll report to Secretary Tugade and we will kick ass.
Yes, Mr. Chair. Fully agreed po.
Kick all these people who are not doing their job, who are corrupt, who are sucking the blood of our people. There can be no excuse for that. Tapos, December 31, 2019, deadline to produce, release, and issue the motorcycle plates. Wala pa rin. Transitory provision na kalagay. LTO is given until December 31, 2019. Today is already 2021. Anong date ngayon? February 5. My gosh. Ano yan? We're taking our time. Do you think the Senate is a window dressing? Nagagawa kami ng batas tapos hindi nyo implement? The main thing wrong with our country is that we do not enforce the law. That's why all of us take an oath to enforce the law. And we have not enforced the law. December 31, Secretary Galvante, meron din ngayon, 2021 na, violation na yan. Yan lang, pwede na kayong kasuhan. June 18 to 19, 2020, oh, kunyari may plant shutdown for disinfection. June 24, 26, plant shutdown due to COVID. Pero umaandar pa rin yan. June 29, 2020, nagsumpisa kayo mag-produce ng motorsiklo, license plates. July 1 to 3, kunyari plant shutdown na naman. Pero kahit na nagsya-shutdown yan, umaandar ang makina, meron kayong mapuproduce kahit na konti. Tama ba yan, Undersecretary? Terrible. So, ladies and gentlemen, I don't want to keep you. We will conduct another hearing on the matter. And the next hearing will be on February 18, 11 a.m. And we will ask you, we will submit our records. And we will make sure that the people concerned who don't do their jobs, we're going to bring the axe down on them from the Senate side. Be forewarned. We thank all the everybody. We're doing this also for the police. I thank General Elazar for his very good answers. But I also make the plea that never mind if we don't know who these people are, there must be every effort to try and apprehend those who kill people. May I have your cooperation with that, General Elazar? I know you to be a good officer.
Yes, Mr. Chair, we will, sir.
In fact, I think you should be Chief PNP. And I think you should have 2 years. All Chief PNP should have 2 years. Not only 1 year or not only 6 months. Para may policy na talagang tuloy-tuloy. And General of the HPG, I'm glad that you have new motorcycles. And please, General Tagun, I'm sure you can completely do your job well. I'm of the belief that you can do it if you want to. Kung gusto, maraming paraan. Kung ayaw, maraming dahilan. All of you are invited to the next meeting, including Secretary Tugade. And forgive me, my passion is irrepressible. You all have to love this country, and we have to win. And we have to start winning. Kung natatalo tayo sa pandemic, mananalo tayo dyan. Kung natatalo tayo dito sa LTO, marami namamatay, mananalo tayo dyan. Depende sa inyong lahat dyan. Kung di nyo gagawin yan, talo tayo. Kung di nyo kayang gawin, umalis na kayo sa gobyerno. Because that's what we're here for. Alright? Thank you all very much. And as Father Gordon, ego te absolvo apicatis tuis in homini patri et spiritu santo. Amen.